Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to today's video. Now in this video I want to show you how to create cinematic looks with the DJI OSMO action camera. Now the word cinematic has become a little bit abused over the years, but basically it means that we are trying to capture our video footage with the looks of the old celluloid film that was taken in camera. So that means we're using a frame rate of 24 frames per second, and in the actual film camera they used to use what's called a 180 degree shutter rule, which meant that the shutter speed was actually twice the actual frame rate of the camera. So in terms of 24 frames per second, we're looking at a shutter speed of about a 48th of a second. Now they use the aperture to control the amount of light, as then the film was at a fixed ISO. In our cameras we've got variable ISO, but it's best to try and keep that to the lowest value so we're getting the least noise and maximum dynamic range. As these cameras have a fixed aperture, it means that we have to reduce the light that reaches the sensor by means of neutral density in order to get us down to that 1/48th or 1/5th of a second if you're shooting 25 frames per second to give us the correct exposure. Now in this video I'm going to show you a filter that's manufactured by a company called Freewell. Now I've got it installed on my action camera here, and it replaces the screw-on cover that is on the action camera when you first get it. Now I had extreme difficulty removing the cover that was on my camera, and I had to use slip joint pliers with a cloth to try and remove it. It was on that tight. Once it's removed, you can actually install these Freewell filters onto the existing lens thread very easily. These filters are nicely machined, finished off in black anodized aluminium with a nice red ring around them. So the actual thread is a perfect fit for the thread on the action camera. Now these filters are really well defined. They've got a 16 layer multi-coat process, scratch proof, dust proof and waterproof, so that they actually seal with the camera. And in addition to that, they've got a hydrophobic coating, so if you get water on there or a fingerprint, they're very easy to clean. So great filters. Actually Freewell produce a range of filters not only for action cameras but for drones as well, so if you're into that sort of market, check out their website. I'll put a link to that in the video description below so you can check out more of their products. Now the filters I've got here are the Freewell Bright Day Pack. Now the Bright Day Pack consists of four filters. So we have the ND8, ND16, ND32 and ND64. So that gives the equivalent of three stops, four stops, five stops and six stops worth of attenuation. So that's normally enough for this bright light conditions. Remember, we're shooting at a fixed aperture of f2.8, so we need to reduce the amount of light. Now as a rule of thumb, if you remember the good old sunny f16 rule, it applies to most equatorial countries. So if you're talking about between the equator and sort of Britain, the f16 or f11 rule should hold good. So if you take the reciprocal of the film speed, so if we're using ISO 100, the reciprocal of that would be 1/100th of your shutter speed, and that would be at f11. So we want to go down to half of that, so that's going to be a 1/50th, so that's going to be f16. And then to get down to the f2.8, we need to go from f16 to f11, so that's one stop, to f8 is two stops, to f5.6 is three stops, to f4 is five stops, to f2.8 is six stops. So as a rule of thumb, we need to attenuate the light reaching the camera by six stops to enable us to get the correct exposure. So in most cases we're going to be using the ND32 or the ND64 filter to achieve the correct exposure. I've not actually checked the lighting levels yet here, it's late afternoon in the UK, but the lighting level should be around about F8 or F11, so we're talking about the ND16 or ND32 filter to allow us to get the correct exposure. Now, trying to achieve the cinematic effect gets over the issue of these cameras with that fixed 2.8 lens running at very high shutter speeds of up to say 1/1000th of a second in bright sunshine. If you were into the Saving Private Ryan looks at the opening of that sequence there, where all the water splashing into the air and all the blood and guts as the soldiers are being machined down, you will see that the droplets of blood and water are actually captured in droplet form. Normal cinematic looks will give those as a stream rather than a droplet effect. So to give that smooth cinematic feel to your videos, we need to be shooting at the old cinematic frame rate and the shutter speed of twice the frame rate. So hopefully in today's video, I'm going to be able to show you how to set up this camera to give you that 1/48th or 1/50th of a second shutter speed and use the right neutral densities to enable you to get that shutter speed. Now, incidentally, these Freewell filters in the Bright Day Pack are a combination filter. They're actually ND and circle polarizing. So in addition to being able to attenuate the light, you can actually use these to reduce the amount of reflections on water or snow or foliage to great effect. So if you want to actually reduce it or improve your skies being in your landscape, then the circular polarizer is a fantastic addition to this filter pack. So let me set up this camera to show you the effect on the landscape behind me. And also I've got some shots which will demonstrate the effect of using the cinematic frame rate and shutter speed versus the ordinary out of camera footage that you get if you haven't got these filters installed. Well, I set up the DJI OSMO action camera on the tripod now so we can see what's going on in the back. Notice I'm in the manual exposure mode so we can actually control both the ISO and the shutter speed. Now, without any filtration on the front of the camera, to achieve a zero EV effect, I'm not to use ISO 100 and the shutter speed is 1/640th of a second. So the light is a little bit down on the F11 rule, but that's the nature of light. So with our exposure at 1/640th, we need to go down to 1/48th to enable us to get twice the frame rate. So we're shooting here at 1080p and 25 frames per second. We can see this indicated on the screen here. It's 1080p, 25 frames per second, 1/640th of a second at ISO 100. First of all, I'm going to install the ND8 filter and see what the shutter speed is when we've got the correct exposure. So I'm just going to screw that onto the front of the action camera. So that threads onto the lens mount. Now to change the exposure, we need to slide the screen across and now click on the shutter speed. And we can adjust the shutter speed until we get the zero EV back again. So hopefully we're going to be going down. That's one EV underexposed, 0.7 underexposed. So at 1/50th of a second, we're actually 0.3 overexposed. So if we went to 1/60th of a second, we're at exactly zero EV. So we're not quite at the exact frame rate for twice the shutter speed, but it's better to have the correct exposure than being overexposed or underexposed. So again, if I slide that back, you can see the effect. Now, if you look at the screen at the moment, there's absolutely no vignetting from these filters and there's absolutely no color shift. Now, to show you the effect of the circular polarizing filter, at the moment, the light is directly over my shoulder, so that is on a zero axis. For maximum cut, you need to be between sort of 90 and 180 degrees. So as I rotate the circular polarizing filter, we may not notice much change in the sky. It's getting brighter, and now it's getting darker. I'm going to turn the camera around so that it's 90 degrees to the sun, and let's see at the different effect we get. So I've oriented the camera now that it's 90 degrees to the sun. So the sun is over to my left. See, the sky is bright. There's very little clouds in that position of the sky. But as I rotate the filter, you can see the circular polarizing effect is having more cut on the sky. You actually see it darkening and it's enhancing those clouds that are in the sky. And now we've achieved maximum cut. And if I continue to rotate, then obviously we'll go back to the non-filtered position. So I'm here testing the OSMO action camera
and I'm using the Freewell Bright Day Pack neutral density stroke circular polarizing filters. They're a combination of a neutral density and polarizing filter combined, so you've got the benefits of both filters in the one package.
Well, that's it for this video. I hope you found that useful. Please do check out that Freewell website. I'll put a link to that in the video description below. And also check out my photographic blog, where I've got a complete review of the Freewell filter system in the review section of the blog. And again, I'll put a link to that in the video description below. And also, if you are a new viewer to my channel, please do subscribe and check out my photographic blog. Again, the link will be in the video description below. On the homepage is the option to join my 3-weekly news group. Now, that's going out to almost 3,000 viewers now every 3 weeks. It's more than a newsletter. It's become a technical publication in its own right. And it's a way of saying thank you for your subscription to my news blog. So that's it for the video. Thanks very much for watching. And as usual, please do take care. And I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.